more story time with Kathleen. And tonight, we have just to go for a little tradition, a little crown royal in honor of Carrot Top. He's a big crown royal guy. He has a lot of it backstage. And he's very, very willing to share. Very nice man. Okay, let's go back. This is where they all were sure they were going to lose, right? They had a whole thing, the trouble-free outcome. They awaited on November 8, 2016. Losing would work out for everybody. Shortly after 8 o'clock that evening, when the unexpected trend, Trump might actually win, seemed confirmed, Don Jr. told a friend that his father, or DJT as he called him, who does that? I'm going to start calling my dad JPM, just to see if he even gets it. He probably won't even know what that means. What? What did you say? Jay, what? Anyway, Don Jr. told his father, looked as if he had seen a ghost. Melania, to whom Donald had made his solemn guarantee that he wouldn't win, was in tears and not of joy. That was a sad clown, not a happy clown. There was, in the space of little more than an hour, in Steve Bannon's not unamused observation, a befuddled Trump morphing into a disbelieving Trump and then into a quite horrified Trump. But still to come was the final transformation. Suddenly, Donald Trump became a man who believed that he deserved to be and was wholly capable of being the President of the United States. So there you have it. On Saturday after the election, Donald received a small group of well-wishers at his triplex apartment in Trump Tower. Even his close friends were still shocked and bewildered. And then there was a dazzle quality to the gathering, but Trump himself was mostly looking at the clock. Rupert Murdoch, his BFF. Heretofore doubtlessly certain Trump was a charlatan and a fool. That's what he said, a charlatan, a fool. And he told his new wife, Jerry Hall, that they would pay a call to the president-elect, but Murdoch was late. Now what does Trumpy do? Rupert's not up.